Get the two pikemen in there. Wagon, two in there. And Max Arbalest. Oh, it's a number at the bottom right, not the top left. Okay. Get that loose. These dudes are expensive, actually.
Golden armor! Dark day for the Emperor! His army's shredded to ribbons! Long may she live! Our slayer of black clads! Hip hip hooray! Long may she live! Our slayer of black clads! Hip hip hooray!
Milady, a strange boat floated past.
Where's Yanko? Twadorn, I sent him into the fields, but he's not returned. Where's Yanko? Twadorn, I sent him into the fields, but he's not returned.
Horns sounded. Meave recognized them at once as those of the Lyrian vanguard. She drew her sword and prepared to face the invader. Yet coming down upon her force were not Nilfgaardians, but bearded warriors clad in leather, horned helmets on their heads. This was not so. The queen could not believe her eyes.
Skellige raiders, This far inland?
But this was no time to be bewildered. Meave spurred her horse. It neighed and reared, and then the twain leapt into the fray.
Reynard, what the devil? Sea raiders here!
I'm coming.
Put our steel to the test.
Oh man. I need to heal or check for that to really kill him fast. I selected him! I selected him.
A reap, a time to sow, and a time to die.
We'll ransack your temples, wipe ourselves on your vestments.
Thank you.
again and again and again.
You want a pass, you gotta pay. Can't let you through elseways.
Ah, should have listened to me, old lady.
Lyria!
Ugh! Got a bad case of rower's back.
One bullet's all I need.
You've got stones, wench!
Give me a time.
Sailed into troubled waters, mate.
Give us all you got!
Abelista, your command.
Damn. Being high morale on this is not good. I'll try that with the heal or not, it's gonna be the same. Except for I can cast it now. See how that goes.
Horn sounded. Meave.
Way to get my morale down.
Reynard, what the devil? Sea Raiders here!
There's a time to reap, a time to sow, and a time to die.
Ha!
Ariel's been chosen. The gods speak to him.
again and again.
We'll ransack your temples! Wipe ourselves on your vestments!
An army's waste of time for one like me. Left, right, left, right.
Council of War. I should have put him there.
Sailed into troubled waters, mate. Can't take it.
One bullet's all I need.
Damn it. Dude, cancel that.
Give me a time.
Got any vettles? Hungry like a wolf, I am. I'm coming.
Stones went.
Gods are blowing fair winds today.
Olga Blackhand's taking on new swabbies. What do you say?
Help! want a pass, you gotta pay. Can't let you through elseways.
Arbalist, at your command.
Got him.
The Skelligers fought hard, fought bravely, brought mayhem. Yet the Queen's ordered, disciplined force won the day. The Islanders seemed entirely undismayed at their defeat. A trait of theirs, I must admit, I've ever admired.
Well, you're right scrappy for landlubbers. Let me Goodmund applaud you for your pluck, Queen. When we sup, me and the lads will drink your health.
That we shall yet see, sir. We must know something first. What brings you this far inland? What drove you from the sea?
Meave asked, crossing her arms.
Ha! What always drives us? Looting and pillaging. The coast's picked clean since long, so we set our longships up the Yaruga for gold and glory!
Amusing. I always assumed you to be honorable folk.
And who dares to claim elsewise?
Your very actions do so. You've attacked a land preoccupied, a land already at war with invaders. But I suppose it makes sense. You've ever feared to attack Imperials?
The Queen prodded gently.
What did you say, wench?
Goodmund had quickly turned red with rage.
I'll prove just how wrong you are, I will! Why, we'll be drinking meat from Nilfgaardian helmets for sundown! Follow me, lads!
Meave smiled as she watched the Islanders gather their gear and prepare to march. She doubted not in the least that Goodmund would honor his pledge.
Nice. Gotta go there.
Here the damage seems not so great.
It appears Nilfgaard's not yet turned its forces towards the capital. We're likely to encounter no more than pathfinders and foragers.
So I hope.
I missed late that year. There we go. Falling rocks again.
Arbalista, your command. I'm a lord, sir.
take any more.
I only loot corpses, but sometimes they're quite fresh.
Her Majesty is exceptional.
Ballista, your command.
We must trust each other.
Okay. Well, there you go. There's something in here.
Nilfgaardian invasion necessitated certain steps. Meave had dispatched scrolls to her garrison commanders, based upon which they were to announce general musters. She'd hoped that by the time she reached Crydam, fresh recruits would be waiting to join her growing force. Alas, the commander of this fort, one Sergeant Griggs, had only bad news.
Your Majesty, I've not the numbers to man the walls even. The call to arms brings few new recruits and more men desert each day. Folk are terrified something awful. They don't believe in victory.
Since love of country seems insufficient motivation,
Meave said, standing up from behind the table,
we must make coin speak. Sergeant, announce that all new recruits will receive twice the usual soldier's pay.
Though costly, Meave's decision brought immediate results. Lured by the promise of gold, townsfolk in droves enlisted with the garrison. The queen left Crydam poorer, but encouraged, as she had a stronger force in tow.
Nothing stirs a soldier's soul quite like coin. The clinkety clink of gold.
I'm gonna call it right now. Because I need to get some lunch. So I'll be back in about an hour or two and we'll either continue this or maybe hop into some Warframe. Catch you guys in a bit.